بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على سنته واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وأما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. First of all, I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us this opportunity to gather together in this time. And as well as I would like to thank my son and brother and all the group and all the brothers and sisters who organize this meeting. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this meeting, these hours, in our hasanat, inshallah, in the day of judgment. As you know, the topic or the series of these classes will be purification of the heart and the soul. Yani our topic mainly is about the heart and the soul, diseases of the heart and its cure and purification. This topic is very important and it is sensitive, as well as it is very deep. It is very important for every Muslim to go through it, to reflect and to understand what we are talking about and how this can be implemented in our life. The heart, generally, to go quickly to the point, is the place of Iman and it is the place of the Kufr. It is the place of Fisq. It is the leader and it is the main organ of the body. And the heart itself is described in the Holy Quran and in the Hadith of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam in different and various types and ways. We will go in this journey with the Quran al-Kareem and the Hadith of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam to know our hearts. As it is described in the Quran, and to know our hearts as it is described by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will talk about also types of the heart, characters of the heart, symptoms, signs, as well as we will go through the barriers, the enemies, obstacles. And of course, all our talk will be based on the Quran and the Sunnah. The sources of this course for those who wants to achieve the knowledge. Number one will be Al Quran Al Kareem. So it is very important to have your copy of the Mus'haf al-Sharif, Al-Qur'an al-Kareem. Also, number two will be the books of Sunnah, يعني Ahadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mainly Al-Bukhari and Muslim, and especially the chapter of heart softness. In Sahih al-Bukhari, you will find the book of Kitab al-Raqa'iq, the book of al-Raqa'iq, softening of the heart. So We will go through some of the ahadith talking about softening of the heart from Sahih al-Bukhari and the other book is Sahih Muslim. We will go through the main book which is very widespread, اللي هو كتاب الأربعين النووية, the 40 نووي حديث. And I recommend this book of Dr. Jamal Zarbouz, one of the best books you can go through understanding a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is known as a commentary on the 40 hadith of Imam al-Nawawi, and it is produced by Dr. Jamal Zarbouz. It is 3 volumes. In this course, we will go with volume 1, hadith number 1, which talks about intention, and hadith number 6. There is a morsel in the body. If it is sound and cure, everything will be sound. If it is diseased, everything will be diseased. It is the heart. Hadith number 6 and hadith number 1 in Al-Arba'in al-Nawawiyya. And this is one of the best explanations. Dr. Zarbouzou got his book from Jami' al-Ulum wal-Hikam of the great Imam Abd al-Rahman ibn Rajab al-Hanbal. Okay. Also, we will have some other books. We cannot miss our great Imam, Shaykh al-Islam, the great scholar Ibn Taymiyyah, Ahmad ibn Abd al-Halim ibn Taymiyyah, one of the top of the top, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. We will go some chapters of his book, Diseases of the Hearts and Their Cures. His student, the great scholar Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, Imam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Juziyyah, also wrote wonderful books regarding the heart and its diseases. And the book will be The Purification of the Soul, by compiled from the work of Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, who made Jami' al-Ulum al-Hikam, and Ibn Qayyim al-Juziyyah, and the third is Al-Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali. Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, we all know that he wrote a wonderful book, Ihya Ulum al-Din, Revival of the Science of the Deen, but it has a lot of weak ahadith and some of Sufism issues. So many scholars took this book and cleared it from the weak ahadith and some of the issues of the Sufi. And then it was the book of Minhaj al-Qasidin by Imam Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi. And we will go through summary of Mukhtasar Minhaj al-Qasidin. مختصر منهاج القاصدين by Imam Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi. Also, he talks a lot about the topic we are talking about, اللي هي the heart and its diseases and its importance. We have also Purification of the Soul. This book is Purification of the Soul, also written or compiled by Dr. Jamal Zarbouz. Purification of the Soul. We will go with chapter 3 and chapter 4. The importance of purification of the soul in the Quran and the Sunnah, as well as the goal and the scope of purification according to the Quran and the Sunnah, and the process of purification. We have some other books. This is one of the best books I recommend also, but it needs hard work. It is the book of Al-Ubudiyya. Al-Ubudiyya, Slave, by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. We have the Arabic version and the English version. So the book of Al-Ubudiyya, Being a True Slave of Allah, by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. Also we have امراض القلوب وشفاؤها. امراض القلوب وشفاؤها by شيخ الاسلام ابن تيميه. There are other books I used to collect regarding this course. Some of them are small books as Weakness of the Faith and How to Cure Your Heart, some Arabic books. How to Rectify Your Heart. This is an Arabic book talking about also diseases of the heart. So this is our curriculum. Inshallah, I try to do my best to cover as much as we can in this course, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the best and to purify our intention and to make us achieve the goal of this meeting. Five. The heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the heart in many ayat in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the heart in many ayat in the Holy Quran, and you will find that some ayat talks about the heart, which is pure, sound, repentant, which is saleem, qalbun saleem, qalbun munib, qalbun mukhbit ila Allah, qalbun yaqsha'ir. The ayat talking about the heart, amazing. When you go through it in the Holy Quran, you will find that it is something you have to think about your heart. And again, is it the heart which is in the chest of every human being? It is a pump made of flesh, and physiologically, anatomically, we say it is made of four chambers, two atria, two ventricles, and it works as a pump pushing the blood to all the body and receiving the deoxygenated blood. And it is a very important organ. Yani it, through the blood, through all the organs of the body. It is flesh. يعني عضل, muscle. And we know that there are coronary arteries supplying the heart itself. And there are valves. I am talking medicine now. Okay? There are many diseases of the heart. Pathological diseases. Acromegaly. Bicuspid valve, if it is narrowed or if it is widened. There may be holes. There are many diseases, physical, pathological diseases of the heart. The Quran talks about diseases of the heart. في قلوبهم مرض. Okay. The Quran talks about hearts that is dead heart. Some hearts are very solid as the rock. Some hearts are very soft. And there is an ayah in the Quran describing the heart is as the place of thinking, reflecting, understanding. Let us go through this ayat before going deep to our topic. The ayah in Surah Al-A'raf and the other ayah Yes. In Surah Al-Hajj. In Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا أَوْ آذَانٌ يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. And Allah says, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارُ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَى الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. And in the other ayah here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, where is it in Surah? رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً. Our Lord, let not our hearts deviate after you have guided us. This is in Surah Al-Imran. Allah describes some hearts that it is sealed. Hearts of the kuffar. The hearts of the munafiqeen, hypocrites. It is sealed. طُبِعَ عَلَيْهَا. أَوَلَمْ يَهْدِ لِلَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْأَرْضَ مِنْ بَعْدِ أَهْلِهَا أَنْ لَوْ نَشَاءُ أَصَبْنَاهُمْ بِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَنَطْبَعُ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ. And the second ayah in Surah Al-A'raf, تِلْكَ الْقُرَى نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَائِهَا وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ فَمَا كَانُوا لِيُؤْمِنُوا بِمَا كَذَّبُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ كَذَلِكَ يَطْبَعُ اللَّهُ عَلَى قُلُوبِ الْكَافِرِينَ. The translation, has it not become clear to those who inherited the earth after its previous people that if we will, we could afflict them for their sins, but we seal over their hearts so they don't hear. Those cities, we relate to you, O Muhammad, some of their news and certainly did their messengers come to them with clear proofs. But they were not to believe in that which they had denied before. Thus does Allah seal over the hearts of the disbeliever. So they have hearts, okay? But it is sealed. We will go through this to know what is the meaning of sealing the hearts of those kuffar. Also regarding the believers now, look to the ayat talking about the hearts of the believer. And take care to see your heart with them, inshallah. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. In Surah Al-Anfal, the hearts of the believer. When Allah is mentioned, it is affected. The believers are only those who, when Allah is mentioned, their hearts become fearful. And when His verses are recited to them, it increases them in faith. And upon their Lord, they rely. The heart of the believers, it is affected. When Allah is mentioned and you are receiving the maw'idah of the Quran and the Sunnah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. This is in Surah Al-Taghabun. No disaster strikes except by the permission of Allah. And whoever believes in Allah, he will guide his heart. He will guide his heart. And Allah is knowing of all things. يعني if a disaster fall on you, what will be your response? If you are a believer, or if you are a kafir, or a munafiq, or a fasiq, the respond here is according to what is in your heart, to your iman, And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will guide your heart if you are a believer. So that the disaster will not destroy you. It will not turn you upside down. And look to the people how they respond if there is a calamity or a disaster falling on them. The believer, he will say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'u. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Oh Allah, help me, support me, back me. Oh Allah, it is something from you. Give me calamity. Yani, I always see this example. You are taking your son to the doctor, he is sick and diseased. Then after some analysis, investigation, I'm sorry, you father, your son has cancer, leukemia in the blood. I had this experience. And there was the father and the mother. The woman screamed, shouted, cried. And the man became more calm a little bit. And he began to repeat, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. They respond here. And what will happen next day? What will happen the coming few months? You are one of two. It is something beyond your hands. Either you are a believer and there is iman in your heart, you will say, okay, everything from Allah. We will ask Allah. We will do our best to cure our son. But at the end of the day, it is something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot blame Allah. You cannot, and you shouldn't start saying, why? Why me? Why my son? And this can deviate you from iman to kufr. So, what is the point here? It is your heart. It is the iman. فَمَنْ رَضِيَ فَلَهُ الرِّضَى. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَمَنْ سَخَطَ فَعَلَيْهِ السُّخْطِ. We are slaves to the Creator. We are slaves. يعني at the end of the day, me, you, your wife, your father, your mother, your son, all of us, slaves. Slaves to the Creator. And we have to believe in this. And this is Islam. Full submission. Submission to Allah, the Creator. And we are living in this dunya to practice slavery towards Him alone. يعني when I am slave to Allah only, I am the greatest free man on the world. I am not a slave to the king or the queen or the president. I am not a slave to a woman. I am not a slave to anything in the world. I am not a slave to my desires. I am slave for Him alone. And this is iman. Where is iman? Where is taqwa? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, At-taqwa ha-huna. At-taqwa ha-huna. At-taqwa ha-huna. And he pointed three times to his heart. According to your iman in your heart, you are acting in this dunya. According to your heart, again, the king of your body, and everything are soldiers. The heart starts the motivation for everything. The heart gives the orders. And we are just reflecting what is in our hearts. And here the ayah is very clear. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَ. The ayah in Surah Al-Taghabun, and it talks about المصيبة. مصيبة يعني disaster. What is the biggest مصيبة in our life? Death, disease. And comes afterwards, loss of money, or trade, or whatever. Any loss of money or things can be, يعني you can gain it again, you can get it back. But death is the end for your son, your daughter, your father. The apparent end in this life, I mean. Disease also is something affect all your life, especially if the illness or the sickness is hard and harsh. So Allah says in the Holy Quran, ما أصاب من مصيبة. No disease strikes except by permission of Allah. This is part of the iman in our heart. Everything is prescribed, created. Nothing haphazard. Nothing in this dunya haphazard. Everything is prescribed. Do you believe or not? While you was a fetus in the womb of your mother, all your lifespan is recorded. The hadith number 4 in Al-Arba'in al-Nawawi. حدثنا الصادق المصدوق إن أحدكم عبد الله بن مسعود, the great Sahabi, said, our beloved, trustful Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that إن أحدكم يجمع خلقه في بطن أمه 40 يوما نطفة سيمن ثم 40 يوما علقة ثم 40 يوما مضغة. So this is 120 days. The fetus, the sperm with the ova, in the womb of the woman. We do nothing. Then after this 120 days, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, then the angels will come to him. And the spirit will be blue. فينفخ فيه الروح. Okay? ثم يؤمر بأربع. And the angel will write. Of course, his sex, male and female, his lifespan, how long will you live, and your deeds, أعمالك. أعمالك. And the determination, the final destination for you. Okay, حاضر. طيب, let me finish this hadith. This is very crazy. يعني now you cannot add 1 hour to your life, you cannot add 1 minute, it is finished. عبد الجليل may be recorded in his, he will live. How long do you want to live? 50 years, 60, الله أعلم. خالد will live 70 years, 2 months, 3 days, 2 hours, 5 seconds. محمود, محمد, حسين, every one of us, his lifespan is fixed, finished. And this will give you some sort of calm. Calm down. If something happens, if you lose somebody, it is his time. Don't blame qadr. Don't blame environment. Don't blame anything. It is fixed. You cannot. Yani, and this is a very important issue regarding the imam. I remember the story. One of our brothers, he went to United States America with his wife and his daughter, a beloved daughter, 7 years, saying to his wife, I'm taking my daughter to bring some milk in early morning. Crossing the road, a car came. Attacked them. The girl was killed on the spot. Again, the mother. Imagine the mother. It is musiba. Musiba. Her own daughter. When she knows, yeah, screaming, shouting, get crazy. Of course, the father also. A huge upset. Disaster, sadness. But at the end of the day, when she began to blame him and they began to talk, why did you take my daughter? Why you didn't leave her in the hotel? What can he say? What can you reply? It is only one answer. Allah created her, and this is her lifespan. Finished. Believe or not, I remember that tsunami, 2005, and I saw the documentary film in BBC4. 250,000 killed within few hours. Okay, earthquake, huge waves, villages destroyed, drone, something yani, 250,000 at least. In few hours. Then they brought a rabbi and preach and one Muslim, and the representative was talking about with them. And because the representative was an atheist, he said, "Why this great toll of death, yeah, Sergius? Why 250,000? Why children and old women die in few hours? Where is God? You say God is mercy? Time. What would you answer? Yeah. What would you answer? It is again Iman. Iman. Who are you? Who are you? Have you created yourself? Have you created your father or your son? What is this soul in your body? Can you guarantee that you will live next year? Or you will live till Ramadan after 2 months? Who gave you this soul? Allah! Who can take this soul at any time? Allah! Believe or not, we are nothing. If we want to compare, we are powerless. We are slaves. Slaves. And Allah gave us everything. Alhamdulillah, we are living, we are sitting, we are talking, we have health, we have money, we have wives, we have everything. Do you reflect on this? Do you believe in this, that this is all of these are blessings and favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So again, it is a matter of iman in the heart. This iman will give you everything regarding peace, tranquility, happiness in dunya and akhirah. It is the link between you and Allah. And to come back, as the Prophet ﷺ said, it is in your heart. It is in your heart. It is in your heart. Okay, we will have a break for 2-3 minutes, inshallah, then we will continue.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah.
We are still in the introduction of this topic. Yeah. And we are going again to say that in Islam, through the Quran and the Sunnah, the heart is the place of iman. The heart is the place of taqwa. The heart is the place of piety. And the heart is the place of kufr. The heart is the place of fisq. The heart is the place of nifaq. And the heart can be sound. And the heart can be diseased. And the heart can be dead. And the heart reflect, understand, respond. It is not only the place of emotions. Whenever we mention the heart, all our attraction goes to issues of love. Because when you love, your heart beats more. But it is not only the place of emotions. Sahih, hatred from the heart, loving from the heart. The heart is the king. As Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali said here, and this is very clear. The heart is the most honorable part of man's body, for it is the part that knows Allah. And it works for Allah and seeks to draw near to Allah and feels the value
of his bounties and favors. The other organs of your body are only followers of the heart, which utilizes them as king utilizes their slaves. King and the soldiers. So if the king in your body is sound, everything will go well. If the king is corrupted and bad, everything will go bad. Whoever knows his heart knows his Lord. Yet most people are ignorant of their hearts and souls. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes in between a man and his heart. And this coming in between is represented in his preventing him from knowing him and being conscious of him, as well as encouraging him and supporting and backing him. But you have your own will. You have your own will. You are not forced. يعني we are accounted because we have our free will. I have a TV and I have my remote control. I can put it into any bad pornography, any bad films, and I can put the TV into benefit channels. You can come to this meeting and this gathering, and you can take your car to a pub. It is your will. It is your will. Where is this willing? The initiative comes from the heart. And when we say the heart, it may be, many scholars goes with the heart itself. And many scholars say it is a spiritual part which we don't know. يعني it is not the brain. الإرادة, the willing, the consciousness, awareness, the motivation. As we mentioned, you will find many ayat in the Quran talking about القلب. قلب يعني heart. ما في الصدور, what is in your chest. الفؤاد, heart. اللب, heart. And we will find the hadith number 6 very clear when the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is the morsel in your body. If it is sound, everything will go sound. If it is diseased, everything will be diseased and corrupted. And this is the heart. Hadith number 6, very, very important and clear hadith. Everyone should memorize it. And I always start with this hadith. Number 6 and hadith number 1. Hadith number 6 عن النعمان بن بشير, the great Sahabi, who said, I hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, that which is lawful is clear, and that which is unlawful is clear. And between the two of them are doubtful matters, about which not many people know. Thus, he who avoids doubtful matters clears himself in regard to his religion and his honor. الحلال بين, الحرام بين, وبينهما أمور مشتبهات لا يعلمهن كثير من الناس. فمن اتقى الشبهات فقد استبرأ لدينه وعرضه. ومن وقع في الشبهات وقع في الحرام. كالراعي يرعى حول الحمى يوشك أن يرتع فيه. But he who falls into doubtful matters falls into that which is unlawful. Like the shepherd who pastures around a sanctuary, all but grazing therein. ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله ألا وهي القلب. Be aware of this. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم finished the hadith saying, truly in the body there is a morsel of flesh which if whole, sound, okay, all the body is sound and okay, whole. And which if it is diseased, or if it be diseased, all the body will be diseased. Truly, this is the heart. This is the heart, your heart.
And the Sheikh Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali explained this in about 40 pages. Beginning by, what is the relation between the start of the hadith, the beginning of the hadith? Halal is clear, haram is clear, and there are some doubtful matters between them. And at the end of the statement, Rasulullah said, there is the heart, the flesh in your body, the morsel. If it is sound, everything will be sound. If it is corrupted, everything is corrupt. What is the relation between talking about halal and haram and talking about the heart? Who can tell me? Why? What is the relation? When Rasul talked about halal and haram, we thought that he will give some examples of haram, some examples of halal, some. But he came at the end of the statement and he said, there is something, if it is sound, everything is okay, heart. If it is corrupted, everything is corrupted, your heart. What is the relation between halal and haram and your heart? If your heart is corrupted, you will go to haram. If your heart is sound, you will not go to haram. Okay, but this is not the point. There is more deep. More deep. Hi, to make it short. Who cares about halal and the haram? Who? Who will ask about this is halal or haram? The believer. If you have iman in your heart, you will ask. If you have weak iman, or you don't have iman, you will never ask. The point here is there iman in your heart pushing you towards pleasing Allah, to avoid what displeases Allah? It is the iman. If your iman is weak, you don't care. You don't care. Yeah, and you are running about everything in this life. I am going to mortgage, I am going to make a transaction, I am going to do something, I am buying this, I am eating this. If you are a real believer, always you will ask yourself, what I am doing is halal or haram? Shall I go to riba? How can I get married to a woman? How can I build a relationship? How can I do this transaction? If there is iman in your heart, you will stop. And you will think. And you will ask. Halal? Okay. Go ahead. Haram? No way. No way to do it. So Rasulullah ﷺ made the link. Halal is clear and haram is clear, and there are many issues which is doubtful matter. Okay, some scholars may know it, but your responsibility is to ask and to fill your heart with the iman. Fill your heart with iman. يعني, what is iman? Loving Allah, iman. Fearing Allah, iman. Relying on Allah, iman. Trusting Allah, iman. Iman. Iman is something embedded in your heart. The relation between you and Allah who created you. Are you a real mu'min, believer, or not? And when we go with Imam Ibn Taymiyyah in the book of Ubudiyyah, you will see that this iman in your heart, if it is not protected, you will lose it. It is a struggle in our life to keep iman in our hearts and to raise it till we die. يعني, it is not just a simple thing to sit down, get a relaxed, oh, I am a mu'min, I am a believer.
you will find the enemies attacking your iman, attacking your heart. And this is the great book of Iman Ibn al-Qayyim. إغاثة اللهفان من مصايد الشيطان. How to rescue you from the trap of the devil. And in this great book, he said that the battlefield is your heart. Shayateen are attacking you. Shayateen al-ins, shayateen al-jinn, and even your soul. Your soul itself, I have desires, I have lusts. I have arrogance in myself. So they went very deep. Analysis of your soul and your heart. And according to the Quran and the Sunnah, the Quran told us how to protect your iman. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. He's whispering. He's coming to you. He will never leave you. He will never leave you. From your birth till the moment your soul is departing. What is he doing for you? Imam Ibn al-Qayyim also in Tafsir al-Mu'awwadhatayn, the great two surahs in the Quran. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ المعوذتان to seek refuge with. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم used to recite these surahs after each salah and before he sleeps. And when he wakes up, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. The enemies, either from inside you, which is your desire, your soul, if you leave it, and the shaitan, and the enemies outside yourself, evil eyes, envious, sorcerers, people who wants to harm you. How to protect yourself from all things? How to protect your iman in your heart? Keep it alive, awareness. Remembering Allah. As he mentioned, Imam Ibn al-Qayyim and Ibn Taymiyyah. According to many ahadith, and one of the great things of remembering Allah is Al-Quran al-Kareem and many ayat, especially قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ آية الكرسي قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. The end of Surah Al-Baqarah. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, should I tell you what is better than fighting the kuffar, killing them, and spending the money for sake of Allah, and doing so and so? The Sahaba said, yes, tell us, Ya Rasulullah, what is the best? He said, ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. ذكر الله, remembering Allah, يعني keep your heart, keep your iman alive. Wake up, alhamdulillah, walking, subhanallah, astaghfirullah, praying the five prayers in its time, going to reciting the Quran, raising your link, tightening your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always in the state of remembrance. This doesn't mean that you become a Sufi or you sit down in the mosque day and night. No. No, remember Allah in every aspect in your life. Remembering Allah when you are with your wife. Remembering Allah when you are with your kids. Remembering Allah with the neighbors. Remembering Allah in your work. Don't be a slave to yourself. Always remember Allah, remembering Allah. And when we go to a hadith al-Bukhari and Muslim, you will see how the Prophet ﷺ warned us from being deeply indulged in dunya, as we are nowadays. Dunya, this worldly, glittering of the world. We don't belong to this world. Let me say it again. We don't belong to this world. have, we belong to the next. We were created in paradise, our father Adam. And we will return back.
فحي على جنات عدن فإنها منازلك الأولى وفيها المخيم.
The great poet that حي على جنات عدن, rush, run, be aware. We will return back. We are very temporary in this world. It is just a few years. And the time is running. Be aware. Build your palace in paradise. Prepare yourself for eternal happiness with Allah who created you. So one of the things which will scratch your iman to forget Allah, to forget al-Jannah, to forget that you are a slave and get some sort of arrogance. The kibr, which one of the main characters of the shayateen. So here, Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us a lot about purifying our heart. And he knows that the matter is not simple. Look to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum wa ajsamikum walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum. And he pointed to his heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily Allah doesn't look at your bodies or your shapes, but he looks at your hearts. And then he pointed to his chest, recorded by Imam Muslim. And when we say hadith recorded by Imam Muslim and al-Bukhari, it is 100% authentic. يعني 100% Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it. No doubt. Allah doesn't look to our features. Allah looks to our heart. What does it mean looking to our heart? Searching about the iman in your heart. Nobody knows what is in your heart. Nobody knows. Although it is reflected in your actions, in your sayings, but the reality, it is only known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of that, you will find hundreds of ayat talking about purify, clean, clear your heart. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَى أَجْسَامِكُمْ. I can deceive all of you. You can deceive others. You can talk as an angel. And in your heart, inside, you are a devil, a worse shaitan. And because of that, one of the things, yani, the secret relation between you and Allah is best, is the best. Yani, when you do something, and nobody knows it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you become very keen to be accepted. Because of that, let us two types of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the best salah after farida? The best salah you pray after salawat al-farida. What is it? Which salah of the nawafil? Tahajjud, salat al-layl. Why it is the best? And it is highly rewarded. And it is the character of the real believers. As Allah said in the Holy Quran, كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. They don't sleep the whole night as we do. The real believers who want to keep their iman and their link with Allah, they give half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. They wake up. They wake up. At night, while we are sleeping, they wake up. And this is the character of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He never missed Salat al-Layl. All the Sahaba. And this is, of course, after doing the fara'id. يعني we wake up for salat al-fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha, and we hasten to the mosques. As men, we have to do our best to pray jama'ah in the mosque. As a man, especially salat al-fajr and salat al-isha. And then comes the light in your face by salat al-layl. Noor, izzah, the honor. How can you wake up and leave your warm bed and take yourself away from your beloved wife and come to make wudu at night and start praying and nobody sees you and there is no benefit at all? You will get nothing in this dunya. You are building your palace in paradise. You are protecting your iman. You are strengthening your iman in your heart. Shaitan will flee. And you can control yourself, control your soul. The other type of worship, which also is a secret between you and Allah, nobody knows. What? Fast. Very good. Siyam. And because of that, you will get the hadith. كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به. يدع شهوته وطعامه وشرابه من أجلي. Allah says in the hadith al-Qudsi. Hadith al-Qudsi يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Allah says. But it is not Quran. It is hadith Qudsi. So this hadith Qudsi, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Allah says, every deed of the son of Adam is for himself. Except fasting, except siyam. It is purely for me. It is completely for me. It is for me. Because you leave your lust, desire. You leave. And you leave eating and drinking for sake of Allah. Yani this cup of water. In July when Ramadan starts. I am very thirsty. And this water is halal. I will never, never, never drink. I am very hungry. Give me a piece of bread. I will never do this. My halal wife is sitting near me. Bye bye. No way. A big distance. Why? Why? Something in my heart. I am fearing Allah. I love Allah. I want Allah. This will guide me in my life. This is, yani, my life should be according to what my Creator, my Lord, my Rabb wants me to do. And again and again, it is the heart. It is the heart. And because of this, one of the worst things we have to fight in ourselves is al-riya. Al-riya, showing. When you do a good deed, it is a good deed, but it is not pure for Allah, you will get nil, zero. It is a good deed, but I am doing it to be praised by you. I am doing it because I will be paid after a while. I am doing this good deed for showing. And the great warning hadith, one of the hadith which make you shake, who are the first three to be thrown to hellfire? The first three to be thrown to hellfire. Mujahid, shaheed, martyr, and student of knowledge or a scholar, and a very generous man, Muslims. But they did this not for sake of Allah. أول من تسعر بهم النار يوم القيامة ثلاثة مجاهد يقال له ماذا فعلت يا رب قتلت
في سبيلك يا رب وقتل، يقال له كذبت، you are a liar. قتلت ليقال شهيد، ليقال جريء، وقد قيل خذوه إلى النار. ماذا فعلت يا رب؟ أنفقت المال في سبيلك، فيقال له كذبت، وإنما أنفقت ليقال كريم. جواب، وقد قيل خذوه إلى النار. ماذا فعلت يا رب؟ تعلمت العلم ونشرت العلم في سبيلك، فيقال كذبت، وإنما فعلت ليقال عالم، خذوه إلى النار. It is very very dangerous if you don't purify your heart. A man fighting the kuffar and he is dead and killed, and in the day of judgment he will be exposed. He was running for booty, he was running for worldly affairs. The other one who seek knowledge, you are not seeking knowledge to clean your heart, to increase your iman, to fear Allah. No, you are a liar. You did it for showing, to argue with others, so that it will be appointed to you. A very good sheikh, a very good knowledgeable man. It will be said to you in the day of judgment, you are a liar. And the generous man, you did it for showing. The point here, this is major hypocrisy. Take care, when we will go about the nifaq, the disease of the heart, you will find minor hypocrisy and major hypocrisy. Major hypocrisy means that no belief in Allah. He is a kafir inside his heart. But apparently, he is doing the actions of the Muslims. This is the major hypocrisy. المنافقون إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار. They are worse than the mushrik. He is kafir inside his heart. His heart is completely black. He doesn't think of Allah. He doesn't think of Akhirah. He doesn't care. But because he is living with us, he is pretending. He is pretending. And he may do some apparent good deeds, but inside his heart, it is completely corrupted. He never fears Allah. He never thinks of doing something for sake of Allah. And this is the same as the kafir when he does a good deed. The kafir doing a good deed. What do you think he will get? A disaster in Somalia. And this George Michael, Misharifi bin Yamin, he said, okay, this 50,000 to Somalia. Oh, there are many orphans in Bangladesh, okay, I will pay $500,000 to build an orphanage in Bangladesh. Okay, very good deeds. What he will get? Yalla, Shuyukh East London. You are Shuyukh East London. According to the Aqeedah, the faith of Islam, according to Hadith Sahih in al-Bukhari, I'm not sure in Bukhari or Muslim, but Hadith Ibn Jud'an, if you know. The same thing at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ ابْنَ جُدْعَانَ كَانَ رَجُلًا يُطْعِمُ الطَّعَامِ يُسْقِي الرُّكْبَانِ يُغِيثُ الْمَلْهُوفِ هَلْ ذَلِكَ نَافِعُهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم القيامة يعني. You said no? لا. إنه لم يقل يوما رب اغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. It will not benefit him in the day of judgment. It may benefit him in dunya. Yes. Allah may give him something in this dunya. And he may be honored, he may be praised, he may get anything. But in akhirah, no way. Rasulullah said he never asked Allah to forgive his sins. Yani, i.e., he was not a believer. And the Rasulullah said, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا نَفْسٌ مُؤْمِنَةٌ. Believer soul. يعني, I believe in Allah who created me. الواحد الأحد.
He, I am his slave, I am returned back to him. I will be accounted in front of him. I seek his refuge. I need his help and forgiveness. I ask him, I believe in this. This is established in my heart. No doubt, no suspicious of this. I may be a sinner, I may fall down, but I return back. And the statement, لا إله إلا الله, محمد رسول الله, testimony. It is something embedded in the heart of the believer, either you are a man or a woman. And this will help us, all of us. And our duty is to flourish it. To flourish it, to keep it, to increase it, to raise it, to raise it. This is our duty. This is our life. This is our life. To worship Him, to obey Him, to seek His forgiveness, to do whatever He wants us to do. Khalas. One of the things that shows slavery in Hajj, when you go to Hajj, Umrah and Hajj, hasten to perform Hajj. Those who delayed Hajj, they are in danger. Try to hasten to perform Hajj as soon as possible. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. حُجُّوا قَبْلَ أَنْ لَا تَحُجُّوا. Do Hajj as soon as you can. And I don't think that anybody here in England, he cannot save 3,000 or 4,000 to perform Hajj. You can go in a cheap package with £2,000. Hajj after 4 months, inshallah. Prepare yourself from now if you didn't perform Hajj al-Farid. Sayyidina Umar said, who can offer Hajj and he didn't perform Hajj, let him die as a Christian or a Jew. Take care. Yeah. Take care, you are dealing with the God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't just accumulate money and save money, and then you become 50 years, you become sick and ill, and at that time you wouldn't be able to perform Hajj and Umrah. By the way, I met a brother in a bookshop, an old man. We were looking to the photo of the Kaaba, and we were talking, then I said to him, how many times you performed Hajj? He said, no, I didn't do Hajj. Why? He looks too old, 70 or 70 or something. Why a Hajj? Why not, brother? He said, because I have many daughters, I want to get them married, and I'm keeping the money to marry my daughters. I said to him, what are you talking about? What is the relation between yourself performing Hajj and your daughter to get married or not? She may not get married in all her life. Allahu A'lam. Nobody knows. But it is your duty towards Allah to perform Hajj. Just keeping money, accumulating money. And if you are 60 years or 70 years, it will be difficult. Now in your age, it is very good to perform Hajj now. 20, 23, 25. Don't delay it. Why I'm talking about Hajj? Hajj is one of the greatest pillars of Islam, as well as Umrah, Umrah and the Hajj. In Hajj, you are a slave to Allah. You show your slavery to Allah. Take off your clothes, all your clothes. Okay, help. Go to Arafat, a valley, there is nothing there. Stay the whole day. Help. Walk, move from Arafah to Muzdalifah. 7-8 kilometers, 2-3 millions. Moving. Okay. Sleep in Muzdalifah. There is no hotels in Muzdalifah. There is no hotels. There is no rooms in Muzdalifah. There is nothing. Put just a cartoon or a piece of paper, sleep on the ground. Rich people here from England, okay, a very nice sleeping bag, okay, no problem. But you are on the ground. You are on the ground. There is nothing, no ceiling.
Why? Sleep. Yes, yes. Sleep. Sleep in Muzdalif. Wake up in the morning. Hadir. Go to Mina. Slaughter the sheep. Hadir. Go to the Kaaba again. Make Tawaf al-Ifada. 1 million. 2 million. 5 million. Imagine you are a dot in an ocean. You cannot move even. The crowd. And then shave your head. Harder. Bald, yes. Shave it all. Where's the handsome man? Where's the garafata? La ya bab. No. No. I'm asleep. Yes, I will obey everything. Through these rocks. Jamarat. In this place. Harder. Kiss this rock, the black stone. Try to kiss it. Or kiss your hand and put your hands on it. If you can't, just point at it. Why? Slave. Slavery. This is our role in this life. Don't be misguided by this civilization. Don't talk a lot about freedom. The real freedom is to be his slave. Otherwise, you are a slave to your desires and lusts. You are a slave to women. You are a slave to money. You are a slave to your king or president or whatever. The only free man is the believer. Al-mu'min al-mu'ahid. And this is the ayah in Surah Al-Jathiyah. أفرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هوى وأضله الله على علم وختم على سمعه وقلبه وجعل على بصره غشاوة. You took yourself, your desires, your lusts as your Lord. You are learning in this dunya for money. Money. Food. Woman. This is the life of animals. An animal. And because of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the kuffar. The kafir is worse than the animal. Adal. In hum kal an'ami bal hum adal. The animal is doing its role. But when Allah gives you this soul, this mind, this heart, this eyes, this ears, and you go astray, you are worse than the animals. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. I guided you. Hadith الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, the day of judgment. يُؤْتَى بِالرَّجُلِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَيُقَالُ لَهُ أَلَمْ أُسَخِّرْ لَكَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ ألم أجعلك ترتع وسخرت لك الأنعام والشمس والقمر وآتيتك أكنت تذكر موقفك هذا أنسيت؟ فيقول العبد الآثم العاصي نسيت يا رب. فيقال له أو فيقول الله له اليوم أنساك كما نسيتني. It will be told to those heedless. Allah will say to them, I gave you everything. I made you life. I gave you the life. I gave you the health. I gave you the eyes, the ears. I let you. You grow up. Tarta'. You do whatever you want. You didn't remember that you are going to in front of me. You didn't remember this day. This kafir or sinner or hypocrite or whatever, he will say, oh Allah, I forgot. So it will be said to him, okay, today I will forget you as you forgot me in your life. So the matters of keeping the iman in the heart is something essential in our life.
And the ayat and the hadith here are a lot. I cannot go through all the ayat. There are يعني tens of the ayat, but I'm just giving this example. Let me say now the ayah in Surah Al-Hajj, talking about the hearts which reflect. In Surah Al-Hajj, Allah says, أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا أَوْ أَذَانٌ يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. Have they not traveled in the land, and have they hearts understand, and their ears wherewith to hear? يعني the hearts reflect, the hearts understand. And Allah says in this ayah very clear that the understanding comes in the heart. Allah says in the other ayah, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. In Surah Al-Shu'ara 98, the day when wealth and the sons avail not, the day when your son and your wealth avail not. Nothing will benefit you in the day of judgment. Don't be deceived. Don't think that you are very happy when you accumulate more and more money. Okay, it is not haram, but it becomes haram when it will deviate you from Allah. The fitna of the money is one of the greatest fitna. Because when your main concern is wealth and money, you will forget. You will be very busy. You will not give time to your law. I remember a brother. He was my neighbor before I moved from Christruhu. I used to wake up for Fajr. Ta'ala, let us go to pray Fajr together. We are neighbors, we can go with one car. He says, I'm sorry, I can't. Why? Because I want to finish my house. I need to go to work very early, 7:30. So I want to go to the mosque. And he said, okay, after 6 months, after I finish, inshallah, I will be with you. After 6 months, he said, oh, I'm sorry. I have to finish the mortgage of my house. I have another work. I have to be early, 8 o'clock. Afterwards, a year and 2 years passed. He's very busy, more busy and busy. And this is the life. And this is what the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam warned us. If you have a valley of gold, you will not be satisfied. You need another valley. You have 10,000, not enough. You want 50. Then it is 100,000. You want 500,000. You want one house here and one house in Algeria, in your country. You want to build 2 houses. One car is not enough. You have a small car, Fiat or Lepta. No, you want X5. You want to buy BMW. As my son told me just a few days, I want to buy a BM. I said to him, what about our Honda? This old Honda is a nice car. So what, Jan? Why to pay 10,000 or 20,000? I don't know about this one. But when you go through this, it is not haram again. But for the believer, be aware. Take care. Take care. And when we will go to the diseases of the heart, you will see that one of the diseases is getting more and more of the halal, to be indulged in more and more of the dunya. You will be attached to dunya. The brother said to me once, I'll build my house to be perfect in everything. I will pay everything to be excellent. The floor, the decoration, the furniture. And then he said it. It will be my paradise. It will be my paradise. And really, I found him very, very attached. Yeah, it is not. This is not our life. Ilaha illallah. Try to see how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived. How the Sahaba lived. We are just talking, yani. Allahumma ja'al rizqa ala Muhammadin kifafa. كفافة. Oh Allah, give us what is necessary for us to live. Sayyida Aisha said, it passes 1 month and 2 months and we don't eat one cooked food. Mafish fire. La ilaha illallah. The room of the Prophet, when you read about his life, 1 meter, 2 meters, that's it. When he prays, Sayyida Aisha, she was sleeping, he has to push her feet. There is no place. And we said, okay, our example is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we are running day and night. Try to detach yourself a little bit, a little bit, step by step. I'm not saying be a monk or stay away or retire. No, try, try, especially when you have a family and you have a woman. Some women are very pious, but many women are very demanding. If Allah gives you a good woman, it will help you greatly in your life and in your deen and in your iman. And this is because of this, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما استفاد المؤمن بعد تقوى الله عز وجل خير له من زوجة صالحة. It will help you very much. But in the contrary, if she is a dodgy woman or a dodgy wife or that, we have to change the bedroom, bring another car. I want a new sharif, silver and gold. Look to my sister. Look to, it will be a hellfire. So the issue I'm talking about this regarding life, our life. Again, work, gain your money in halal, but do your best. Don't be attached to the dunya. Many of the sahaba were very rich. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf was a millionaire. Uthman ibn Affan, Amir al-Mu'mineen. When there was the army, he said to the Prophet ﷺ, I will pay everything, all the expenses for the army, I will pay for it. And the Rasul ﷺ said, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَانَ مَا فَعَلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْسِ. Rasul one day, he said, everyone please donate, as we hear in the mosque, donate generously. Do you know what Abu Bakr did and what Umar ibn al-Khattab? Umar ibn al-Khattab said, at that time, alhamdulillah, I had some money. He went running and he said, I will be more than Abu Bakr. And he brought his money to the Prophet. And the Rasulullah s.a.w. asked him, how much is this? He said, it is half of all what I have. Half of it. Then came Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr put, the Rasulullah s.a.w. asked him, what is this, Abu Bakr? He said, this is all what I have. All what I have. This would never happen in nowadays. Nobody can reach yani, part of Abu Bakr, 1/10, 100. Then the Rasulullah asked him, what did you leave for your family? He said, I left with them Allah and His message. So again, I want to say, you may be very rich, but your heart can still be attached to Allah with the great fitna here, the great fitna of the money, the great fitna of loving something and being attached to it. And all of this will come when we talk about how the heart can be affected with all of this. Yani, I think that we have made the introduction to our topic. Inshallah, next week we will go through the ayat of Surah Al-Baqarah from ayah 1, verse 1 till verse 20. It divides human being into three categories. Believers, whom they have the pious, clean hearts, who believe of the unseen. And two ayat will talk about the kuffar, the disbelievers, with dead hearts. And 12 ayah talking about the hypocrites who are with corrupted hearts. So we will start with ayat Surah Al-Baqarah and how it will mention the hearts of the three types of the human being. All the human beings are either you are a believer or a kafir or a hypocrite. Yani a kafir pretending to be
and living with the hippo, with the believers. And we will go, inshallah, through hadith number one, intention. All your deeds are based on intention. Everyone will be rewarded or punished according to his intention. Take care of this hadith. It is half of the religion. Hadith number six, there is a morsel in the body. If it is sound, everything is sound. It is the heart. And inshallah, then we will go through the other books. Okay, if there is any, jazakumullah khair, wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. If there is any question, quickly, the brother said 2 or 3 minutes and we have to go to the mosque. Yes, any questions, any comments, any suggestions? Fadda.
You mentioned about heart, as a pumping organ of blood. Is it the heart pumping from, or you think it's the hippocampus in the head? Forehead?
Very good question, and the answer of it needs yani 1 hour to answer your question. And the many scholars, as Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen said, it is the heart. It is the place of iman and the kufr and the place of fisq, and it is the motivation. Other scholars say it is something spiritual. And it may be the heart itself or something related between the brain and the heart. But what is it exactly? Nobody knows. But when the Quran talks, the Quran says heart. So you can go through this or this. Allahu a'lam. Yes, any other questions? Any comments? Any suggestions? Okay. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.